नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभाम्। नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। I welcome all of you with my love and respect. I welcome all the living and practicing Hindus from all over the world. And all the Sarvajna Peetha Kartas, Yajamans, Manifestors, Sarvaparityagis, Srimahans, Mahans, Kotari, Tanidhar, Visitors, Viewers, Kayakalpa Yoga participants, Kailasas E Gurukul students, Kailasas NHU students, everyone, I welcome all of you with my love and respect.
நித்யானந்தம். In the year 1978, the Pingala Nama Samvatsara of the Hindu calendar, when Paramashiva descended from Kailasa and graced the humanity in the form of His Divine Holiness Swamiji, He performed the Leela of meditating on Dipavala Kundu in Tiruvannamalai and effortlessly manifesting the Nirvikalpa Samadhi and the 360 degree vision through the body He had assumed for this avatara. Swamiji did this leela when he was 12 years old during the evening time just after the sunset of Rishabha Masa Purnima Divaikasi Purnami. This divine leela of Paramashiva is celebrated as the Nityananda Purnima Brahmotsavam every year, which culminates on the Nityananda Purnima day on Vaikasi Purnami. This year, Sharvari Samvatsara, the Nityananda Purnima Brahmotsavam, starts tomorrow on the 27th May Indian Standard Time with the Dhajarohanam between 9:05 a.m. and 9:25 a.m. in the Mithuna Lagnam. On this auspicious occasion, today, all the Sarvajna Peethas and the Nityanandeshwara Paramashiva Devasthanas across the globe are offering the sacred Mandagapadi offering at the feet of His Divine Holiness Swamiji and inviting His Divine Holiness Swamiji for His grace, blessings to be showered on the whole cosmos during this Nityananda Purnima Brahmotsavam. We, all the Sarvajna Peethas across the globe, offer our Dandavat Pranams with love and deep respect at the feet of His Divine Holiness Swamiji and offer this Mandagapadi today. ॐ नित्यानन्दं परमसुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। नित्यानंदेश्वर परम शिव समारंभाम् नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्ति मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। ललाटे त्रिपुंड्री निटिल कृत कस्तूरी तिलकः पुरन्माला धार स्फुरित कटिकौपी नवसनः दधानो दुस्तारं शिरसि फणिराजं शशिकलाम् प्रदीप सर्वेषां अरुणगिरियोगी विजयते। ओम न कर्मणा न प्रजया धने न त्यागे नैके अमृतत्वमानशुः परेण नाकन्निहितं गुहायां विभ्राजते तत्यतयो विशन्ति वेदांत विज्ञान सुनिश्चितार्था संन्यास योगात् यतय शुद्ध सत्वाः ते ब्रह्मलोके तु परान्तकाले परामृतात् परिमुच्यन्ति सर्वे दह्रं विपापं परमेश्मभूतं यत्पुण्डरीकं पुरमध्यसग्रस्थं तत्रापि दह्रं गगनं विशोकस्तस्मिन् यदन्तस्तदुपासितव्यं यो वेदादौ स्वरः प्रोक्तो वेदान्ते च प्रतिष्ठितः तस्य प्रकृतिलीनस्य यः परस्तमहेश्वरः। श्री कैलासोन्नत द्वादशांत श्यामला पीठारूढ श्री मीनाक्षी सुंदरेश्वरा भिन्न स्वरूप परशिव पुत्र रत्न कुमार गुरुमण्य तुल्यावतार श्री पार्वती स्तन्यपान लब्ध दिव्य ज्ञान विश्रुत सकल निगमागम सार भूत द्राविड वेद प्रवक्तृ श्रीमत् परम शिव करुणा समधिगत मुक्तामय चतुरश्रयान गीयमान छत्र चामर श्रीचिह्नकाहलादि समस्त विरदावल्यलंकृत ज्ञान विज्ञान चक्रवर्ती सर्वजन संघ सद्यो निर्वाण दीक्षा व्ययापवर्क वर्ष विश्राण जीमूत परमत कलभ केसरी शैव सिद्धांत स्थापनाचार्य श्री राजाधिराज पांड्य महाराज गुरु क्षपण शाक्यादि महांधकार निवारण ज्ञान भानु वीक्षणानर्हार्ह ध्वजोच्छेदन पूर्वक श्रीमत् ऋषभध्वज स्थापक शैव समय कर्तृ सर्वज्ञ पीठारूढ श्री जगद्गुरु श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक स्वामी वागीश सुंदर माणिक्य वाचक स्वामीनाम अवतार भूत श्री ज्ञान संबंध स्वामी पुनरुद्धृत श्यामला पीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रिनवत्युत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान अरुणगिरि योगीश्वर परंपरागत अरुणाचल सर्वज्ञ पीठ गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत कांची कैलास सर्वज्ञ पीठ त्रयस्त्रिंशदुत्तर द्विशत तम गुरु महासन्निधान नित्योत्सव नित्य मंगल नित्य कल्याण नित्य रजित कैलास परंपरागत आदि कैलास नित्यानंद पीठ महासंस्थान महासिंहासन पीठ कर्ता साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कैलास परंपरागत वैवस्वतमनु इक्ष्वाकु हरिश्चंद्र भगीरथ श्रीरामचंद्र शूरसेन इत्याद्यनवच्छिन्न सार्वभौम चक्रवर्ति परंपरागत चतुष्षष्टि योगिनी मंडित चतुष्षष्टि संप्रदाय प्रवर्तक मनुधर्म शासन सूर्य वंश प्राप्त सर्वज्ञ पीठ सुरांगि साम्राज्य मूर्धाभिषिक्त चूड़ामणे साक्षात् श्री परम शिव समुद्भूत कैलास कपिल महागुरु पुनरुद्धृत महानिर्वाणी पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री महामंडलेश्वर साक्षात् श्री परम शिव सिंहासनाभिषिक्त समस्त गणनायक श्री महागणपति समारंभ अनवच्छिन्न पीठाधीश्वर गुरु परंपरा प्राप्त अटल पीठ अष्टोत्तर सहस्र तम अष्टोत्तर सहस्र श्री अटल पीठाधीश्वर धर्म मुक्ति स्वर्ग पुरस्वर्ण पीठ त्रयोविंश गुरु महासन्निधान कैलास परंपरागत आदिपीठ सर्वज्ञ पीठ जगद्गुरो श्री कैलास पुनरुद्धारक श्री कैलास परमाचार्य श्रीमत् परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्यवर्य सच्चिदानंद प्रणव स्वरूप श्रोत्रिय ब्रह्मनिष्ठ श्रीमज्जगद्गुरु श्रील श्री भगवत श्री नित्यानंद परम शिव श्री ज्ञान संबंध देशिक परमाचार्य स्वामिन् अत्रागत्य परिपाल्य च अस्मान् विज्ञान वितरणेन विजयी भव जय जय। धूप ओ ओम धूरसि धूर्म धूर्वन्तं धूर्वतयोस्मान् धूर्वदितं धूर्वयं वयं धूर्वामस्तं देवानामसि सस्थितमं पप्रितमं चुक्ततमं वह्नितमं देवहूतममहृतमसि अविर्धानं दृगम्हत्वमात्वार्मित्रस्य त्वा चक्षुषा प्रेक्षेमाभ्यर्मा संविक्ता मात्वाहि ओम श्री सर्वदेव देवी कृपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः धूपमाघ्रापयामि ओम उद्दीप्य स्वजातवेदो पघ्न निरृतिं मम पशुभिश्च मह्यमावह जीवनं च दिशो दिशा मानो हि किंति जातवेदो कामश्वं पुरुषं जगत् अभिभ्रदघ्न आगहि श्रियामा परिपातय ओम श्री सर्वदेव देवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः एकहारती दीपं संदर्शयामि ओम मधुवातारतायते मधुक्षरन्ति सिंधवः माद्वीर्ण संतोषधीः मधुनक्तमुतोषसि मधुमत्पार्थिव संरजः मधुद्यौरस्तु नः पिता मधुमान्नो वनस्पतिर्मधुमाघम् अस्तु सूर्यः माद्वीर्गावो भवन्तु नः मधु 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 ओम श्री सर्वदेव देवी स्वरूपाय भगवते श्री नित्यानंद परमशिवाय नमः नानाविधानि समस्त नैवेद्यानि निवेदयामि कर्पूरनीराजनम् ओम सोमो वाये तस्य राज्यमादत्ते यो राजा सन्राज्यो वा सोमेन यजते देवसुवामेतानि हवीषि भवन्ति य एतावन्तो वै देवानागुं सवाः अयेवास्मै सवान् प्रयच्छन्ति आरात्रिकं समर्पयामि भगवत्श्री नित्यानंद परमशिव चरणकमलेभ्यो नमः
Listen. Paramashiva's message directly from Kailasa today, revealing the secret treasures through Sarvajnanotragama. Paramashiva's response to Subramanya asked some questions to Paramashiva about the nature of Pashu and Pasa. He never questions about the Pati. He only asks how I can experience more Pati. You need to know this beautiful verse. I'll recite from Sarvajnanotragama. Patischa kimvido nyeyas Satikare Satikara Patestitaha Shivascha Kidrisha Prokta Yotikara Vivarjitaha I'll read the translation. How the essential nature of Pati, who being established in the specific state of authority, performs the fivefold cosmic function, could be known. How the essential nature of Lord Shiva is above and free from the specific state of authority has been explained. Understand? He is not questioning the authority of the Paramashiva. He is only asking how the binary logic and cosmic logic is made to coexist together. Understand? Listen. If you understand how the binary logic of the universe you are experiencing and multidimensional logic of the cosmos happening, how these two are fitting, like how the gears in gearboxes get clutched and the power is transmitted, and how and when they get unclutched when it is not needed to be transmitted. He is only asking about the functionality of cosmic logic empowering binary logic. Understand? He is not questioning the authority of Pati. He is not doubting the powerful existence of the cosmic logic. He is only asking how it is happening, explain to me. Now I will tell you. Understand? If you know how binary logic under which you are all caught is empowered by cosmic logic, and where cosmic logic empowers binary logic, where cosmic logic keeps itself away from binary logic, where cosmic logic is above the perception of binary logic, it is like how cosmic logic creates binary logic, where it sustains binary logic, where it destroys binary logic, where it puts the binary logic into delusion, and where it lifts the binary logic and liberates it. That's it. You are all small gears of binary logic. Parameshwara, Paramashiva is the large cosmic logic wheel. When that cosmic logic wheel touches your gear and empowers you, awakens you, triggers you, and when it withdraws, when you, triggered by Paramashiva, empowered by Paramashiva, starts deluding, you have your own individual supernal effulgence and get deluded. And when you realize the power is from cosmic logic, not from individual binary logic, and rest back in samadhi. This whole flow is Shivajnana. This whole flow is Parama Shivajnana. Listen. Anyone understands this whole flow is liberated immediately. Liberation happens by understanding of this simple knowledge. It's too simple. That's the most beautiful thing. It's too simple. Do you understand how the car functions? Any automobile, there will be shaft through which power is transmitted into gearbox, and different gears are there, which is connected to the wheel, which actually moves the vehicle. Those gears come and get connected to the power gear. So understand, the power gear is the cosmic logic. Paramashiva, Parameshwara. When that gear is rotating, this each gears which empowers the wheel, sometimes the only the front two wheels are powered, sometimes all four wheels are powered. This gears which connected to the wheels come and get connected to the power gear and move the vehicle. When the vehicle need not be moved, or the speed need to be increased, that means the gears need to be changed, this gear which is connected to power gear moves out. Either the other gear comes and gets clutched, or if the vehicle need to stop, no gear comes and the whole vehicle just stops. Understand this principle. The power gear, the source power gear, is Parameshwara, Paramashiva. The individual gears which comes and gets connected is individual soul, binary logic. You, Pashu. Pashu gets empowered by Pati. Sometimes Pati empowers Pashu. Sometimes Pati maintains the speed of the Pashu. Sometimes Pati withdraws from Pashu. Sometimes Pashu starts getting deluded. It has its own independent supernal effulgence without getting connected to Pati. Then sometimes Pati liberates Pashu from that delusion. Understand, Pashu, bound self, is binary logic of this world, this universe, empowered by cosmic logic, Parama Shiva, the source power gear. If you know when is the principle, when is the source gear empowering, and when it is withdrawing, when Paramashiva is empowering you, individual soul, when he is neutral, when he is withdrawing, when he is letting you fall into dilution and delusion, when he liberates. Understand? This simple secret is the most wonderful Paramashiva Jnana. Paramashiva is revealing in this Sarvajnanotragama. I'll read the further verses and give you the deeper revelations. Tamras iyaivatu hematvam antarlinam yatastitam antarlinam tatangyeyam shivatvam utkalasyatu. It is to be known that just as goldness exists concealed in copper, even so Shivatva remains latent in an embodied self. Rasasiddham yadatamram hematvam pradipatyate tatatmanyana sammandat Shivatvam pradipatyate. Just as copper attains permanently the nature of being gold by the proper treatment with relevant alchemic substance, even so the embodied self attains Shivatva by the supreme knowledge gained by it through Shiva's grace. I tell you, you will become what you hope as you. You will become what you hope as you. You will become what you consciously desire as you. You will become what you consciously visualize as you. Listen to these secrets. The good news is your conscious visualization, your conscious declaration, your conscious decision is highly revered in cosmos. Your conscious visualization is highly revered in cosmos. I tell you, joy, sweetness, enlightenment, Paramashivatva, all this. If you just consciously decide, they start manifesting as reality. If you see Paramashiva's revelation, what he reveals in these verses, is very clear. Even when you think you are a bound self, Shivatva exists in you. Understand? This is the secret he is telling to his own son. I tell you, ultimately, intellectuals who don't have experience can go on fighting whether Dvaita is real, Visishta Dvaita is real, Advaita is real. they can go on fighting for their mental satisfaction without getting into the truth. Only when you get into the truth, you will understand all of them are real truth at various levels of the cosmic logic. And Shuddhadvaitam is the complete vision of the cosmic logic. Shuddhadvaitam is not a logic or a philosophy. It is primary principle. Listen. Listen to this clearly. Sound of Dakshinamurti and silence of Dakshinamurti need to be understood in reality. See, the silence of Dakshinamurti is not the soundlessness. Any sound you can only hear in certain decibel. If it goes below the decibel, you can't hear. If it goes above the decibel, you can't hear. Dakshinamurti's silence is above decibel. The decibel which you can't hear, beyond your capability of hearing, that decibel sound is Dakshinamurti's silence. So Dakshinamurti's silence is not soundlessness. It is beyond the sound you can hear. Same way, listen carefully. Dakshinamurti's silence is not soundlessness. It is beyond the sound which you can grasp, perceive, hear. The human ear has a dynamic range of the threshold of 120 to 130 decibel. You can neither hear below 120 decibel nor you can hear above 120 decibel. Sorry, 0 to 120. To 130, I can say 0 to 130 decibel. Listen carefully. Human ear has a dynamic range of 0 decibel to 130 decibel. If something is below the 0 decibel, you can't hear. Something is above the 130 decibel, you can't hear. Dakshinamurti's silence is above the 130 decibel. It is not soundlessness. It is the sound which is beyond your capability to perceive, beyond your range. Same way, Dakshinamurti's visual silence. See, Dakshinamurti's verbal silence is the sound which is beyond your perception. Same way, Dakshinamurti's visual silence is not darkness where nothing exists. No, it is supernal effulgence where all your ability to visualize disappears into his supernal effulgence. Like 7 colors of the rainbow disappear into the sun's bright shining. Your ability to visualize dissolves, disappears into the supernal effulgence of Dakshinamurti. Understand? The supernal effulgence of Dakshinamurti and supernal silence of Dakshinamurti. then you will understand the right knowledge, right clue about the existence of Paramashivatva. If you understand this one truth, today you can manifest powers. The common frequency the human ear can hear is like a 20 to 2000 hertz, 0 decibel to 130 decibel maximum. 20 to 20,000 hertz are 0 to 130 decibel. That's it. If it is below 20 hertz, you can't hear. If it is above 20,000 hertz, you can't hear. Dakshinamurti's silence is above 20,000 hertz. I can give you one small example. Very simple. Actually, I have done this in those days when I used to live in Bidadi, a small group of disciples. Even now, our Kailasavasis in Bidadi can try this. I'll first explain. If you sit in front of our banyan tree, under a banyan tree, and few people sitting in the Sabdarishi rocks in Ramanagara hill, the Ramanagara hill, there is a 7 rock under which there are caves where all the 7 rishis lived. Sabdarishis, even now they are living. That 7 rocks represents 7 Sabdarishis. It is their energy field. Few people should sit under the banyan tree and few people should go there and sit. And you can have a telephone connection, conversation. Just have that fork, you call that spoon fork, vibrating fork. Keep one fork under banyan tree, tuning fork. Keep one fork in that rock, the Sabdarishi rocks. Just vibrate the tuning fork in banyan tree. You will see that the fork on the Sabdarishi rock will vibrate intensely. You can try it today. You can video record it. Because this banyan tree and that Sabdarishi rock is deeply connected through a different frequency than what you understand. Through supernal effulgence, they are connected. All the Sabdarishis sit there and listen to Paramashiva's Vedas and Upanishads and Agama teachings. The tuning fork, the resonance, matching a frequency will simply happen between our banyan tree and that Sabdarishi rock. You can check it. I think the distance physically may be 2-3 kilometer. At least 2-3 kilometer. And I am talking about the air distance, not through road. By air, it must be at least 2-3 kilometers. but this tuning fork will vibrate the frequency for the 2-3 kilometer without any time gap. Maybe our Gurukul Balasans and Rishi Advait, Mahadvait can take them and try to demonstrate it after lockdown. I think lockdown is, whenever lockdown is over, you can demonstrate. Once you demonstrate this to the Gurukul Balasans, I'll make them manifest the next level powers. Listen. All of you who are initiated disciples, get a tuning fork and the pendulum for today and tomorrow's power manifestation during the quality art session. You just keep the tuning fork in front of your third eye. From here, I'll vibrate them. I'll just reveal my supernal effulgence. We may be thousands of kilometers, miles apart. From here, I'll vibrate them. You will see intensely how the tuning fork vibrates. Understand? Because you don't hear, don't think, sound does not exist. Because you can't see, don't think, visualizations does not exist. Because you don't feel, don't think, higher frequencies does not exist. Because you have not realized Paramashivatva, don't think it does not exist. That is the conclusion. Understand these four statements. Keep the fork, the tuning fork and pendulum today or tomorrow. During the courtyard sessions, I will demonstrate it to all of you. And through this, I will confirm wherever you are, I am entangling with you. The quantum entanglement is happening. The state of Paramashiva, face of Paramashiva is manifested in you, infused into you through this supernal effulgence. It is the physical confirmation. I am vibrating your inner space in the space of Paramashiva. So today, get a tuning fork and pendulum. I'll vibrate the tuning fork and rotate the pendulum intensely from here. For all of you to understand, your being is entangled with Paramashiva. Clearly, Paramashiva explains here. Inside the copper exists the original state of gold. Inside the bound soul exists the original state of Shivatvam. Inside you, Parama Shivatva exists. Just the proper process, rasavada, need to be done. That is why he uses beautiful word. Rasasiddham yatatamram. The alchemy process need to be done for you to manifest your Paramashivatva. Entangling with Paramashiva, quantum entanglement with Paramashiva is the rasasiddham for you to manifest Paramashivatva. Get today tuning fork and pendulum. for courtyard session. If you have, even now get it. Today and tomorrow, I'll make all of you experience this quantum entanglement, Rasa Siddham, as Paramashiva explains. As Paramashiva reveals it to Subramanya, understand? I am not at all interested in fighting whether Dvaita is true or Visishtadvaita is true or Advaita is true or Eganmavada is true or Veda Veda. I am interested in making you Paramashiva. Ultimate Paramashiva is manifesting through this being only to make you all manifest Paramashiva. So get tuning fork and pendulum. I'll make you all experience this quantum entanglement wherever you are, all over the world. And I'll give you exactly what Paramashiva has given to Subramanya. Now Paramashiva will give the same thing through this being to all of you. So, I know many people don't have tuning fork and pendulum ready. So, I'll give you time. Get it? If possible, both or at least one for courtyard session. I'll entangle all of you in quantum entanglement with Paramashiva and make, see, what Paramashiva is giving to Subramanya through this verses, I'll give you. If you don't have pendulum, you can even have your Rudraksha mala. You can just hold it and hang straight. That also can act as a pendulum. So get it for courtyard session. I'll put you all in quantum entanglement with Paramashiva. So now, with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam. The state, space, powers, being, superconsciousness, and Kailasa of Paramashiva, the eternal bliss, Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. The eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.